Welcome back to my channel. I'm Bola, also known as Strictly Dishes. It's another beautiful day for another beautiful recipe. And today I bring you this amazing oha soup all the way from Eastern Nigeria. If this is the first time you're finding this channel, please click on the subscribe button because that will make my day. And to all my amazing subscribers, I say thank you so much. You guys are amazing and you guys are the real deal. So sit back, let's do this together. So the first thing we're going to use for this particular oha soup is the base, and I'm using some palm kernel extract. I washed, pound, boiled and pounded this and extracted the oil, and so I just put that in the pot, and I'm going to make sure that that boils before I add any other thing. So how are you doing? How is work? How's family? And how is business? Yes, the next thing I'm going to be adding is my meat stock. You can add any meat stock or fish stock that you have available. So I just added some meat stock, and I'm going to allow this to boil and also taste before I add any seasoning at all. It is very important that you follow this particular procedure. And the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put my stockfish. Can you see lots and lots of stockfish and lots of yellow pepper? This particular soup requires pepper to heighten the flavor. I'm also using some crayfish, and I'm going to add ogiri. You see, this particular ogiri is a must in making your oha soup because this is an Igbo soup. And you can't have oha, onugbu, or any of all those soups without having ogiri. So please look for fresh, nice ogiri and add to your soup. And it's going to also help to heighten the flavor. I'm going to add some seasoning cube to this, and I am going to just stir everything together. You can see I added the stockfish early because I wanted to really cook, because I haven't cooked the stockfish at all. The next thing I'm going to add is some beef. Yes, I've already parboiled this beef, but not fully cooked, and also the goat's meat. So I'm adding both beef and goat's meat. You know, at this time you can play with the proteins, whatever proteins you have, beef, everything, intestines, ovals, anything you want, you can add at this time. So this time you can see the pot is already looking loaded. Yes, or rather, I just closed it. The next thing I'm going to add is my cocoyam, or also edi. Yes, I actually blended this because, my dear, I like the soft life. So I just blend. Some people pound theirs. For me, I blended and I just added it to the soup. And the next thing is I'm going to stir everything together. You see, this edi is the thickener. Some people use ofo, some people use achi, but for me, I prefer to use edi for my oha soup. The next thing is uziza. Yes, why do I add uziza? Some people don't add uziza, but I add uziza to my oha soup because uziza brings out heat. Uziza is actually a hot leaf, as some people call it, so it adds more heat and it adds flavor to the soup. Can you see how this pot of oha soup is looking? I can't even turn it because this soup, my dear, I don't even know the word. I'm sure before the end of this video, I'll know the word to use. So if you're still here at this time, haven't subscribed to this channel, what are you waiting for? Please click on the subscribe button because that will make my day. Share, send in your comments. And the next thing I am adding is the oha leaf. Yes, oha leaf, as some people say, shouldn't be cut with knife. You can use your hands to just divide this into two. I cut some, I didn't cut some, because at the end of the day, everything is still going to enter the soup. And one thing I do about my oha leaf is, once I put this leaf into the pot, I make sure that the pot is getting off the fire almost immediately, because I don't like my oha leaf cooked. I like to still see it green. I like to still chew it, and that's how I like my own oha leaf. And this particular oha soup, it is ready to eat. So I think if you're still having issues in preparing your oha soup, this particular video, then this is for you. The next thing is for us to just plate. I would like to know, which swallow would you be using for this oha soup? For me today, I'm not going to be using any swallow. I'm just going to sit down and just lick this soup. Yes, but I also like to know in the comment section which swallow you think best goes with oha? Well, for me, this is my own opinion, not yours. I think akpu is the best. And when you make this for friends and family and they ask you, where did you learn how to cook lakopro? Please give us a credit. Tell them Strictly Dishes taught you how to cook lakopro. Till next time I come your way, I remain your girl Strictly Dishes saying bye.